three-minute rounds of Muay Thai.
Jonathan Haggerty's got a really wide stance. He likes to keep his elbows flared out, so expect Kuzmin to really start utilizing those kicks to the body.
You see that quick closing of the distance right there that Haggerty did and caught him with that leg kick.
Yeah, we talked about it with, you know, Abasov and Lee. The only way to kind of erase a weight miss is just to come out there and put on a great performance. And that's really what I'm expecting from Jonathan Haggerty. I think he really wants to come in here and really showcase all the skills that he's got. Put that weight miss behind you, because right now it doesn't really matter in here against Vladimir Kuzmin, who's switching stances a lot early on.
Feature bout lead card, top of the hour, exclusively on Prime Video, will be the main card with five more huge fights tonight here in Singapore.
Haggerty's jumping back and forth. Usually when he switches stances, he's gonna fire immediately. So when he switches to southpaw, he's looking to fake that push kick and really enter in really quick.
Looks like there's a little mouse above Haggerty's, beside Haggerty's left eye.
Yeah, I think he got touched early on from that first shot that Kuzmin thrown.
Yeah, when they came into that clinch.
Ooh. Spinning back kick there from Kuzmin.
That was nice. That was a perfect example of skating to where the puck is gonna be. He knew that Haggerty was gonna try to angle out that way, and he threw that spin kick to the side and caught Haggerty as he was moving.
Haggerty typically does a good job with his jabs or his push kicks of freezing his opponents, but Kuzmin here just floating really well between stances, especially, and not allowing Haggerty to freeze him and actually dictating the distance management between these two.
Yeah, feints coming from Kuzmin too. And
Kuzmin said, I gotta move more, pull him towards me. When you pressure Haggerty, he sometimes squats down a little bit.
Yeah, that was an interesting tell that, you know, Kuzmin was able to point out from us, right? And he's trying to do that right by throwing all these feints, and you can see the pressure that's coming from Kuzmin. I expected Haggerty to be pushing forward and Kuzmin to be on his back foot, but Kuzmin is going forward and showing us a new level to his game.
Yeah, I'm a bit surprised by the pressure that he's putting forward as well.
I think Haggerty's having a hard time dealing with this pressure because he might not have expected it. He might assume that, you know, Kuzmin was going to go backwards. He was going to be able to one going forward. Next hand combination, Haggerty says he's fine. Wouldn't mind seeing Kuzmin go to the body when Haggerty covers up like that. Ooh, Haggerty's the one going to the body.
Yeah, left hook to the body from Haggerty and then push kick from Kuzmin. 10 seconds, round one.
Kuzmin's doing a good job of when Haggerty, when they both decide to close the distance, he's landing multi-punch combination on the inside through a nice little uppercut there with an overhand.
Kuzmin in a catch weight bout.
I want to see what kind of adjustments Haggerty makes here. Just understanding that the game plan might not be unfolding the way that he wants, and how can he change things up to work in his favor? He's definitely bringing that flyweight speed up with him here to Bantamweight, but Kuzmin seems to be matching him in the speed department as well. Rich, how do you like to deal with somebody that's constantly switching stances like this?
It's actually more difficult to deal with a fighter who's switching stances all the time, one that does it effectively, than, say, for example, a southpaw.
That was a head kick. And then a straight right on the attack, Jonathan Haggerty with two to go.
Biggest shot of the fight so far landed by Haggerty was a beautiful high kick.
And he blocks the high kick from Kuzmin.
Well, Haggerty needs to take advantage of this and not let him walk this thing off.
Haggerty going up top again. Couple of lefts from Kuzmin.
Yeah, that was the corner advice for Vladimir Kuzmin, was to utilize those hands more. Don't get caught up in a kicking game. They want him to push forward, utilize those hands. Haggerty's having a much better second round here.
Kuzmin switches again to southpaw. 120 to go in the fight. Feature bout on this lead card has lived up to the billing to this point. Combination there from Kuzmin and another.
And this is where Kuzmin does his best work when he, you know, he's floating here with the footwork. He makes Haggerty miss and then he comes on the inside and makes him pay for the miss.
Don't let him take it too much, John. Come on, fire back.
Body kick from Haggerty. Kuzmin counters with a left to the body. 45 seconds left in the fight.
He seems to have figured out this kicking game. He's keeping his elbows a little bit tighter to his body, right? He's defending well. His footwork is on point. But Vladimir, you can see how the change is kind of affected here. Haggerty figured out the kicking game, and now it forces Kuzmin to go utilize the hands.
Incredible stuff from both men. The best of the best on the planet being featured here in one championship with 10 seconds to go. Kuzmin and Haggerty toe-to-toe. Trading blows one final time.
I like that little hop over the low kick thrown by Haggerty.
Great job of dumping and then using those dumps to set up the elbows. And he's pretty much negated all that, so Haggerty's ability to close the distance and elbow on the inside is gone.
Again, beautiful high kick. No tell, no switch. Just able to wrap that leg up there. Kuzmin needs to put pressure on. He needs to stop allowing Haggerty to come in and out and control the distance with that, those kicks of his.
Kuzmin cutting off the angle here, looking to walk it down. 2.5 to go in the fight.
Good check to a lean back right there from Vladimir Kuzmin.
Kuzmin grabs the leg, spinning back elbow, countered by Haggerty.
Of course, Haggerty to throw an air ball right there with the elbow. Good movement from Vladimir Kuzmin. You can hear the corner of the Nolze Academy right there for Jonathan Haggerty, just telling him to be more aggressive, to go out there and to throw that right high kick because it's there, and just to stay active and keep pushing. Because right now it's razor close, and anybody could take this round. But right now it looks like Vladimir Kuzmin is showing the aggression, landing more of the shots.
Nearly halfway through this final round. Kuzmin with another left hook. High kick, straight right, Haggerty. Good action from both.
Yeah, this is so back and forth between these two guys.
Oh, that was nice. Right as Haggerty was putting weight down on that leg, Vladimir swept it up from underneath him.
1-2 from Haggerty. 70 seconds in the fight. Body kick Haggerty and another. Kuzmin on the retreat, now he attacks back.
He does that nice switching, like a skipping switch kick right there where Kuzmin thinks he's gonna throw the kick and he backs up and then he's able to close the distance, yeah.
He set it up the same way. He threw the leg kick early and then threw it like he was gonna do it, but he came in with the elbow.
Good stuff from Jonathan Haggerty from the UK. The Russian Kuzmin, 40 seconds.
Nice catch and counter from Kuzmin.
And then the body shot, the hook, and then top of the head with a right elbow from Kuzmin.
Oh, this one's close. It's anybody's ball game at this point in time. Good knee shield right there from Kuzmin. Defensive inside that clinch. You're right, Rich. Kuzmin's doing a great job of shutting down the activity that Haggerty usually shows inside that clinch. And that could be the size.
Yeah, I think that's what's been the problem for Haggerty is these go-to tools that he typically uses, the push kick, the ability to clinch and dump and set up the elbows. He hasn't been able to go to his go-to things.
What a way to close the show here by Haggerty and Kuzmin. This one comes to the end, and I don't know, Mitch Chilson.
Jonathan Haggerty!